Everybody took all the other hats. Armani. This has just been the ultimate blessing, but it goes by so fast. it just seemed like yesterday I was just a small buck tooth freshman coming in here. Just my pants sagging, backwards hat. It's just crazy how much this place has changed me. I don't think the program or the coaches know, but because of the change that I went through, going through this program, my family experienced the change as well. I just want to share a quick story with my mother. Not here, I wish she could be here, but she was going through a tough time, a real tough time at home, and things were getting kind of crazy back at home. It was a lot to handle. Losing people left and right. It was going through a tough time, but it kind of forced me to be strong, and this program kind of backed me up with that. It was a huge help. It was the main reason why I made the change I made as a person. And just seeing me go through that change, seeing me fight, seeing me stay strong, it kind of gave my family a boost at home. And now my mom, she has a new job as a medical assistant. She went to school actually for like a year as a medical assistant. And when I used to call her with my frustrations and tell her, like, I can't do it. This homework is hard. I can't do it. I'm not playing. What am I going to school for? And she used to always tell me, you know, tough it out. And when she seen me do that, she kind of got up and decided to do something herself. And she completed school for a year, and now she had a job at the hospital as a medical assistant. And so it's just been crazy how this program, the trickle-down effect, the nominal effect that it has in my life. So I just want to thank everybody, from behind the scenes, from AB to Elliot to Wilch. You know, every time, you know, we have multiple talks where, you know, the first 15 minutes I'm tuned in, but then after that, but in those first 15 minutes though, I always said something, and I always say something. No, man, you know it's all love, and you know, we had some talks on the phone that, you know, you've given me advice and wisdom that I'll hold on to forever and change my life, and I'll pass it on to my kids. Coach Casey, I just want to thank you so much for, you know, attempting to be cool. But your efforts were well recognized. No, man, I love you so much, man. You know, right in your van, you know, just having talks that go everywhere. Our talks went around the world, and it was just amazing just to talk to a coach like that. You know, some players feel that they have to be a certain way around their coaches, but just you guys made us feel so comfortable, and I just thank you for that. Coach Pete, man, I came in here 5 years ago, and you were just a chubby coach. Like, you're a chubby coach. And I was like, I got a chubby coach. You've given me, it's just the way you are, how you just always, you seem to be so poised, but then when somebody flushes you, just turn into a tomato, and it's just all oh, red, guitar, but it's, man, it's, you guys, as a unit, it's just so fun, it's fun, I enjoy coming to practice every day. I got some friends who play college ball at, you know, different places. I have friends who play Division I, Division II, and sometimes they tell me they go to practice, and it's like, oh man, I gotta go to practice. I'm like, why are you mad? Oh man, I gotta go to practice. I look forward to coming to practice. I get dressed to go to practice. I'm in a locker room putting on a black sleeve, a white sleeve, a red shoe, a black shoe. I'm like, we got practice. And it's just, you gotta make practice fun, everything fun, and you're just so comfortable. So I wanna thank you guys for that. Coach Leslie, in the beginning, the word trust, you know, Bruce threw around the word trust, and honestly, in the beginning, I didn't trust you because I thought I knew everything. I was a big head, I thought I knew everything. I didn't trust you. It was hard for me to trust you. It's like, come on, I want to play. But it was, you were working with me, you were building something. And now, you know, hindsight's always 20/20. Now I see what happened. I'm so glad that I toughed it out, stuck with you. Because now I can honestly trust you, and I love you. You're a great man, you know, a father figure. You know, just hearing some of the stories that your father went through, and me kind of having a similar path to my father. Actually, you were the reason that one day I called my father and talked to him for about 2 or 3 hours, and I forgave him. Because I grew up with so much hate for him, and I hated him. And after just hearing you talk about the relationship with your father, and just after you just giving us little things, you give us every day the little things. I mean, little do you know, I put those things in my pocket, and I listen, and I keep those things with me. And I made some decisions that, you know, changed my life for the better. All of you guys, thank you so much. To my brothers, to my players, man, I heard an interesting quote. It was, "You are the sum of the people you spend the most time with." And so, a lot of you guys up here telling me stories about me and you know, how I got this award or how I'm so this, I'm so that. It's just all just a piece of all of you guys put together. And it's me. I learned something from each and every one of you guys. It's not like I'm just some amazing human being. I'm far from it. I'm just learning from you guys and taking pieces. I like investing in people's lives. And I literally try my best to invest in each and every one of your lives and learn something and take it. I'm literally just the sum of you guys. I'm a bit uncoordinated now because of guitar. I got that from him. Two left feet. And I'm like, okay. You stuck with me, you know, but guys. You guys are amazing, man. And you guys are amazing. I can truly say I love you guys. When I use the word love, I really mean it. A lot of people throw that word around. You know, I really love you guys, man. And it's funny how each and every one of you, I've literally had either a conversation with, an inside joke with, or something that we can, like, connect on. You can be like, you know what? You're my boy, LyDell. And that's what it's all about. How much am I doing for you guys? How am I changing you guys' life? How much am I investing? I want to thank you guys so much. Yeah, it's just been an amazing journey. We had a hell of a season, you know, but we always compare our season to last year. And it's kind of unfortunate because, you know, we did go farther than last year, but if you look at where we were ranked before and how people doubted us before and what we did, we had an amazing season. And we came out on top. We're winners. I don't like to call it win or lose. I like to call it results. It's the results of what you put in before. So this next season, I want you guys to look at it like, are we going to win or are we going to lose? I want you guys to look at it, what is our result going to be to the work that we put in before this next season? Whatever you put in is what you get out. So if you guys really go hard, no matter what you look like, we never passed the eye test. Never passed the eye test. I mean, look at Joe. He looks like an accountant or something. My man Connor rather coming to the gym, kicking the ball, dribbling the ball. I mean, we've never passed the eye test, but the work that we put in and our result, that's what it is. So my best advice for you guys is to work your butts off, continue to invest in each other's lives, continue to care about each other and